Don't forget, we're here at the 45th annual Tamworth Country Music Festival, and I've been to 43 of them.
Yeah, okay. I was just going to say one number for you.
Oh, I've missed two.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness me. But I was doing other things.
Okay.
Don't be so personal.
Right.
The variety of country music is endless during the festival, with over 700 performers, 2,800 shows across 120 different venues. We've got performers number 699
in today.
We do. I only say that because they're young.
Yes.
They're young.
Yeah.
And they were at my show. When I first saw them, they were only like knee-high to a grasshopper, just passing puberty. Their mother was playing drums. She was abusing me all the time. and they played down the arcade and did my gig down there, but they've gone on to huge success since. It's Brother3. Good morning, you gorgeous boys. How are you?
Yeah, we're good. How are you?
Afternoon by 6 minutes.
Oh, afternoon by 6 minutes.
Oh, okay. That's sweet.
So, guys, tell us a little bit about yourselves and what's been happening, 2016.
We released our album not exactly a year ago, but yeah, last year in Tamworth.
Pretty much a year ago.
Yeah, and from there we went out on tour. We did pretty much the east coast of Australia, down Melbourne way all the way up to Queensland, and it was amazing. We had a lot of fun. We spent 3 months, 4 months on the road with each other, and it was horrible in that respect. I mean,
if you can spend more than 1 month with Tazen,
the worst part was a 13-hour drive in the same car as Tazen. I
don't have a mic, so I can't defend myself.
He can't defend himself. He hasn't got a mic, so it's great. But no, look, it was awesome. It was really fun, and we were really excited to get back to Tamworth because it's like another home from home. I think a lot of people say that because it's such a big festival. There's so much music and there's so much love, and we see everyone every year now. We were just dreading meeting up with you, Pixie, because you know there's always that moment where we see you and go, oh, great, here it goes again.
Mate, look, it's been an absolute, for me, seeing acts like yourself over the years, and especially you young guys, when you were so full of beans and energy. And now look at you. You've grown.
Tazen's grown outwards.
Yeah, you've grown considerably in the industry, and it's just wonderful to see. It really is.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, we put a lot of effort and time into our band and our life. It's like, yeah, when it first started, and a lot of food. Yeah, well. Come on, it's radio. We've got great bodies for radio.
Yes.
I've got a good face for radio. Thanks for bringing that up.
No, but we love what we do, and I think that's why people appreciate it, because we really, really love it, and it's amazing to get that love back.
That's what happens when you love it.
Exactly.
It goes out to the audience. If you're comfortable, they're comfortable, and you guys know that.
Yeah, for sure. Exactly.
The first time I saw you, I thought, "There's look out. Here they come. This is going to be good. It's going to be good watching this." Yeah.
Yeah, watching us fall off stage and stuff. Yeah,
oh, yeah, your mother went ass out of you.
Oh, you were there.
I kept telling you to pick on her all the time because she was just with that stupid hat she had on.
That hat got stolen when we were on
Thank God.
Our older brother stole it and burned it.
Stolen and then got a Facebook page called Mum's Hat. Great.
So what's your mother doing now? She's sitting at home worrying?
She's actually coming up today to Tamworth.
Oh, God help us.
She's staying somewhere else though.
We have less to stress about, she has less to worry about.
You better watch out, she'll come looking for you soon.
Oh yeah. That'll be the
day. She always kept a wary eye on me, put it
We know you.
Alright guys, you got your guitars out. Why don't you do us a little song for now, and we'll come
featuring
back.
Pixie Jenkins?
Featuring Pixie.
Oh, here's one.
When his fiddle's out, his fiddle out. He's looking to fiddle.
You just can't. Really, you have trouble with that every time.
Alright guys, tell us a bit about this song and what are you going to do for us?
We're going to do a song off the album that we recorded the album, like I said, we released it last year, so we recorded it a bit over a year ago. And this is a cover called Little Lion Man by Mumford & Sons. And they're probably one of our biggest inspirations, one of our favourite bands, because You know, they make this really nice organic music, and
and I've got a mic.
Tay's got a mic.
Oh, great. Oh, this is.
So this is Little Lime Man. On Sunday, Blazers. Which was amazing. Oh, Blazers, yeah. And 900 people in the crowd. It was awesome. Absolutely insane. But yeah, we have two more shows coming up that we should probably advertise. We've got one in tomorrow, actually, at about 4 o'clock it starts, and it's at the Long Yard. And one next Sunday at West Blazers again. And yeah, we're really looking forward to those shows because, yeah, they're like our three main shows. So we've got two left of our main shows.
And it's pocket money, for God's sake.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's it. You know, we need money for Maccas.
Yeah.
Exactly. Feel the fire.
We didn't get the gold card where we got a free meal. We used to get free meals off the gold card. And we didn't get that.
We used to get the free town.
We have mum didn't buy it for us.
Mic, no one can hear you.
Oh, they can hear you.
Oh, he's pretty loud, I suppose.
It's volumes.
Oh, and no one to talk.
So, guys, talk a little bit more, but how many more shows do you guys got here in Tamworth?
So we have, the two main ones, yeah. And then we've got one actually tonight with Graham Roger. We're doing a little, he's doing a tribute show, and we're playing the Bee Gees, because everyone calls us the Bee Gees. it's better than Hanson, so. But, you know, we've got that, and then we've got, what else, is that all we have? God, we're so, it's not, we're using on 29 shows.
See, it's good that you can do three shows now and get the same amount of people.
Exactly, that's it. Well, more.
Have you been down to see the Fudge Lady, the old gig?
Hey?
Have you been down to see the Fudge Lady, the old gig?
No.
She didn't recognise me.
No.
Oh, she'd love to see you.
She'd love to see you. She'd be a number one customer, look at you.
Well, just be like what everyone else has been doing. Just go around and jump on front of stages and
well, that's it. But now
Australian.
We're walking around. We get to see the festival for the first time ever, pretty much. You know, every time we came up, especially before X Factor, it was 29 gigs.
Yeah.
Every 5 minutes, we were just running around crazy. It was insane.
Were you disappointed?
What do you mean?
Were you disappointed with X Factor? Were you in any way?
X Factor.
We know why we lost.
Come on, we had Tazen in the band. If it was Brothers Duo, we would have gone further. But you know,
what the hell is going on here?
We've got to go see Pixies' show.
He's sick on Tazen Day. That's what's going on.
Yeah, that's right.
Because he hasn't got his mic.
He hasn't got a mic, so he can't defend. It's great. It's just an open target.
Pixie
can get in there. Go on, have a stab. Look, honestly, it makes
Pixie
you feel better.
Pixie will defend the potatoes.
Yeah, it's better about yourself.
Have a stab. Where are you stabbed?
There's a lot. You can't miss.
Up to the hilt.
Still wouldn't feel it.
X Factor was it was a completely different experience. We went on there because we had nothing left to lose. You know, we'd done the work beforehand. A lot of people go on X Factor with no experience, no real, you know,
just hoping to.
Yeah, just hoping that it'll just take off. And you know, we'd done the work, we'd done the gigs, we'd done the hard hours. We built up our fan base a little bit, and then when we went on the show, it was like it wasn't going to ruin us, but it wasn't. It might not, you know, nothing might come out of it, but it could be a big.
Exactly,
it was a risk, and it was, but. Luckily, it did go for us. I mean, a lot of people did comment and say we weren't ourselves.
Well, you got your shot. They shined you up a bit.
Yeah, that's it. They polished us up. They,
put us in suits.
Well, it was a bit, and it was it was kind of good.
I see you've gone back to your old stuff.
The first time we put on a suit.
I never worn a suit before that day.
Never will again, though.
They tried to shine you up.
Yeah, but look, honestly, and the songs we did, some of them were a bit, 5 Seconds of Summer. We would never sing their songs in One Direction and things. But it also kind of opened us to say, you know, maybe we can do some of these other songs and make them our own. You know what I mean? See, when we actually did them on X Factor, it was more of a carbon copy of their song. Yeah. You know, it was just this is the song, sing it. Mm-hmm. And now what we've done is taken that and we've said, look, we can't do everything that way. Let's try and make everything ourselves. Everything our own. So if you do come to our shows, you'll notice we do a lot of covers, but they're not anything like the songs.
They're Brothers Three
versions, exactly. They're harmonies, they're organic, and that's it. And that's what we really like.
How'd you learn these words?
I know, it's like I'm eloquent.
What's that?
Another word. I have the best words, I'm full of words, I have the best words.
Why do you think I'm doing
the best talking words?
You should be the president!
You can't,
The trick is just getting him to stop. Stop talking.
Well, because we were talking to the Wolf Brothers earlier, you know, the same sort of thing with them guys, you know, they were telling us that they got to be themselves a lot.
Yeah, and that's lucky, you know, because a lot of people have that complaint that they cannot do what they want to do. I mean, even our audition song, we auditioned with Safe and Sound, we didn't get to choose that. Mm. We didn't get to go, we're going to come in and audition, and, you know, they go, what song are you going to sing?
Mm.
And we go, we're going to do this one. If they say they don't like it, you don't do it. If they do like it, you know what I mean? It's everything is controlled. And I mean, obviously there has to be some control because it is live TV and it is very dangerous. I mean, if you just let everyone do what they want to. But yeah, no, exactly. I mean, you wouldn't let Taser walk, but he'd walk on in bloody trackies and thongs with socks under the thongs and then a singlet.
I did that hat song. I was walking around in Ugg boots.
Ugg boots and trackies. And a singlet.
And a fluoro pink. Yeah. Sims.
Good Aussie Sheila.
That look.
Only on Wednesdays, mate. Only on Wednesdays.
It was just the Ugg boot thing.
I can see how you'd mistake him.
Pixie's a potato too.
Do not talk about moves in front of me. God's gift to older men.
So guys, same thing that I asked the Wolf Brothers before, Did you ever think it would, like, you know, catapult you into doing what you're doing now?
When we first went on there, I mean, like, you never go on to a TV show. I mean, unless you're really up yourself and cocky, like Pixie. You never go on to a TV show.
I won New Faces. Shut up. It was 1984, but I won it.
But you never go on to a show going, this is going to make my career. I'm going to be so famous. I'm going to do this and everyone's going to love it. So, I think most of the time we were kind of going, oh, what if we're hated?
But Kieran cried.
I cried on TV.
He cried cried after boot camp because he was scared we were going to get kicked out. He was on the floor crying.
That's a lie. I cried in the live shows.
Because he disappointed Danny Minogue.
If you're going to tell everyone I'm crying, you'll at least say the right thing. Okay? It was on live shows.
You can dish it but can't take it, Camden.
He's got a mic.
His name's Tazen, by the way. I mean, call him Tamsin, but you know.
No, it's the Tazen thing. It just sounds like he's going to shoot me with something.
Taser?
Tazen.
It's an aggressive name. Tazen.
Remember the Tazen me, bro? Stop Tazen me, bro.
Tazen me. Yeah, we're going to get a Taser. Don't worry, anyway. Enough of this. This is going bad.
Taser me?
So, guys, having fun traveling around, with the blokes we've been growing up with, so, how much fun is it?
It's so much work and so much effort. Like, I mean, obviously everyone who comes in here does touring and who is a musician for their life, who is, their job is being a musician, will say it is so much more work than it seems. I mean, everyone sees the glamorous side. Everyone sees the, you're 2 hours on stage and that's it. You sign things and you sell CDs and it looks amazing, it looks great. You've got this nice, chic, polished show and it's like, great, awesome. That would be an ideal job. You get paid. Shut up. You get paid to do that. And it would be like,
he's just always interrupting. I was going to say, our first 7 years as a band, we basically gave Mum a debt.
Yeah, definitely. It was,
which explains what she used to wear on stage here in town.
Which explains what we wore on stage here in town.
No, well, you could afford the clothes and she couldn't. She was in that daggy old thing with the hat.
Well, the hat got a Facebook page. Yeah, it got followers.
Hashtag Mum's hat.
I think it had something about 700 or 800.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Well, that's more than I've got. Jeez, for a hat?
For a hat.
Switch him off.
I just realised that.
So it was a lot of hard work and
exactly. And I mean, we're nowhere near made it. We haven't. We've only just started what we. What we want to be us. Yeah, exactly. I mean, look at in 100 years' time, we'll be like Pixie.
Wow, that was
we just want to, we want to keep going, keep moving on and keep living our life as musicians. We'll always be touring. It doesn't matter if we've got one person in the audience, we'll always be playing gigs. It doesn't matter.
And that is what makes you guys good. That is exactly what I said when I first saw you back then. I said, these guys are going to love because they like doing it.
Yeah.
No matter the hardships, broken strings, PO's not working, crap hairstyles, boobs, doesn't matter. You will keep doing it, right? It doesn't matter.
No, exactly. It's
and that's what it's all about. That's what makes you
good. Oh, thank you so much, Pixie.
Well, guys, thanks very much for coming to CAAMA and giving us a song. And good luck with everything.
Thank you so much. And it's so good to have you here because if you weren't here, it would be the worst interview ever. It would just be all over the shop. Oh, God.
I'd just be asking inappropriate
questions. No, exactly. You've got your
fat brother over here instead of me.
You were complaining about us picking on him too much, so I'm just sharing.
Yeah, now you're hopping around.
You're the new me.
I don't lie to you.
All right, guys, thanks very much for coming in. Enjoy the rest of the festival.
We will. We'll
hope you have a great time. And, Pix, we're going to go into one of these songs. I don't know. I'm gonna check on Todd Williams. He's no relation, but I know him. He's a good bloke. He won the Toast Road of Tamworth.
Yes.
A couple of years ago.
Yeah. So, you've been listening to the Brothers3
yes.
on CAAMA Radio, King FM, right out of Mbunjwa, going right around Australia. The awesome, fantastic Brothers3. We'll be back in a very short while.
Told you it was awesome, guys.
We're out. Thank you so much.
He must have thought that was wallpaper radio.